This is the thing with the Browns, man. Every year in November, no matter what's going on, they force us to question why we care about anything in the world.
Yeah.
Everyone else gets to watch a football team and like live or die with them, and they go have ups and downs, and even, you know, obviously if you're the Redskins, like, you know, you get it. But like everyone else, like, you know, there's an ebb and a flow. Maybe you're good, maybe you're bad. The
yeah.
Browns take it to a different level.
There's a level of existential dread watching
yes.
the Browns that you don't get otherwise, I don't think.
Questioning every decision that led you to this point in your life.
Kind of and questioning like, whether there's like a cosmic bias against us, because it does seem that we're able to, you know, we lose when we win, when we do it in these fantastic ways. So
we also lose like, when we lose too.
Yeah, that's true. And we do that all the time. I don't know,
yeah.
like, what we're supposed to do. We've stuck with this team for such a long time, and we're doing so in the hopes that one day it's all going to be worth it, like the long-suffering fan base. But like we said, there is no bottom. It seems to just get worse and worse the entire way that we go. So I guess what I'm saying is I don't think we're going to win out.
Oh, man, this is – it's just also, like, to also be put in this position now, too, where, like, we have to defend Myles Garrett
yeah,
with our
right.
fandom is also really dirty. It makes me feel awful. Like, I don't like Mason Rudolph as a person or as a player.
Yeah. This actually like, puts the Steelers in a really interesting position because, like, they should probably bench Mason Rudolph, but can you bench the guy that – it was just like,
no.
We just tried to kill. He played horribly. The worst thing for them is that he like endears himself to the team.
Also, another thing that's really sad is before this happened, I had this thought of like, oh, this is what it must have felt like to be the Steelers playing us for the last 20 years, where even if you don't play well, you just know the other team's quarterback sucks. It doesn't make a difference. Like, yeah, you'll like stumble your way to 20 points, and like you just know, even if you're playing okay – like, he just, like, sucks. He just fucking sucks.
Yeah, there was a 0% chance of him pulling that game out. Like, once we got ahead, you didn't really have to worry all that much. Even though, like I said, we tried to give them the game and they couldn't take it. And that's what the Browns did for so many years against the Steelers. It was like, how many opportunities can you blow? So it was fun to have the shoe on the other foot for a bit. And then we just, like, ruined it. And now we have this gross taste in our mouths.
Yeah, the taste of assault.
Yeah, exactly. I am glad that they just kind of wrapped like so we're recording this it's a little before noon Central Time on Friday after the game. I'm glad the NFL just came out like he's suspended, they're done with it, we can I guess kind of move forward.
Yeah,
and that it wasn't
smart.
Lingering throughout the whole weekend. We could use a new storyline coming up, like we need Cooper Kupp or somebody to rob a liquor store. So that we can just stop hearing about this. We need the news cycle to move on.
Cooper Kupp takes the mayor of Los Angeles hostage.
We need that sort of distraction right now because this is just going to be like a slow news day today. All the NFL shows on Sunday are just going to kind of lead with this. It's just going to be gross. And we as Cleveland fans have plenty of reasons to feel bad about our football team. We don't need more. We definitely don't need the national media like piling onto our team. And it's justified in this case, but like, Jesus
Christ.
Sure don't. Like, we've been through enough.